Okay, big issue. Well, actually, a super big issue. I have the what do we call it? I got the spray can with titanium silver, and I'm spray painting the car. I started with the hood, the back end of it. Just today, and I went through like an entire can. It started leaving drops, and it did not go smooth. It was a metallic type. It just didn't come smooth out of the can. So I'm happy in one respect because it was $7 the can, but in the other respect, it left drops heavier. Anyway, so my method with it is to sand it down with. You can use the 2 120, and then you can hike it up to the 400 grit, and then that's the smoothest. And then tape it down around all of the lights, put the tape on, and your window, and let it go. But so for $21, I'm gonna paint this car. I swear it's gonna get better. But the outdoors are the what really oxidizes it extra. And this is a terrible tragedy with all of these particular makes and models of this car. I see them out there on the road, and they, oh, look, it's just the same oxidation problem. So that paint was just like the bad batch, and it really did not go well. Anyway, so that was my fun for the day as I'm doing that. Does that sound my fun? I have a run by that now. I have to make more clarity with that word. My fun. Yeah, well, anyway, so yeah, then we're talking about big funeral, little funeral, and I'm in my head going, well, the big funeral has the pizzazz events of networking and socialization, and do I want to be in this club or that club or those people, or do I get work through you? Or do I not? Or I do I not bother? I don't even want to wash my hands in the same room with you. Do I end up in all of the little what do we call it? The petty squares of the checkers of the backgammon, which level of association? Oh, big funerals are so exciting, aren't they? And they're a big money blow. And like one of my grandmas, she had a big funeral with the police entourage and all. And big money blow on this, like, it wasn't necessary. I still to this day say no, but I don't believe that networking helped. I don't believe that police entourage helps, the motorcade. I don't believe that helped when I'm looking at the children, from that event, and the cousins and all that. I don't know. Some of them have been successful since financially, but not in this town. They left this village, and so I'm not sure if that entourage was in effect that escalated them in business. But that is something they like to do. They like to put those entourages, events, with the motorcades. Now, I don't know. I don't know. I think that's excessive. But in this life, in this world, it is such a blam, isn't it? If you don't show your blam, what is. Who are you? You're no blam. Well then, I don't want to talk to you. You're nobody. I don't want to. So you have that group of, we call them society networkers, society clingers that require that. They require big weddings and big funerals. That makes them feel that they are successful, that they are of meat, of value, that they themselves are of meat. You know what I'm saying? And without that event, without that, are they a success now? Are they just a drivel in off into the desert? Just a drivel off into the woods? I didn't have a big funeral. I didn't, there was no big wedding. Just a drivel off into the woods. Well, I had a small wedding, and it ended up being a drivel off event for me. So I can say, in my situation, yes, small wedding, not helpful network-wise at all. That small group, you know, your family, you call, your close friend, family, you know, I think I had less than 20 people there, less than 15. When the group is that small, they're just not the group that is something that sits under you as a foundation or a base. So like if I need a networking for work or networking for life, there wasn't anybody there. I had nobody. That group, that small group of mine under 15, was completely useless. They have not helped me. They have not helped me at all. I've just been, just thanks my dad still is my friend, you know, thanks that he is still my friend. And that's that. But when we're looking now at the big blam event of a funeral, the blam event of, what is it? Oh my gosh, a wedding. I'm gonna say big weddings, yes. If you need the hype in life, you know, or if you're gonna be just go out and live in a yurt and be self-sufficient, and your life is kind of set up and you already know that, then you don't need the big wedding. You don't need that event. And the big funeral is who for? It's for the children after. It's not for the person who died, it's for the children and their children's children. It's for their networking moment. You know, oh yes, she was my great-great. Oh yes, she was my great-great. Or she was my aunt, or my second aunt, or whatever. You know. So as much as a lot of us in this, what are we, I'm a Gen X, and a lot of these baby boomers are saying, we're not doing big funerals. We're just we're all getting cremated, or going to the giant snowman events and getting melted there, just running, you know, full turkey naked in and saying, I'm killing myself. Yeah, well, those types of events, they are not doing the big, you know, here you are with the ashes, you have these cremated ashes now. Everybody has those. Nobody wants these coffins. So we're in the big cremated ashes, and it's just a bore, you know, to sit at a service, you know, have a whole bunch of people there. And it's just a bore. But unfortunately, with that bore was the networking moment. You see, all those people that you invite, the 100, the 200, etc., they are, I don't know, can I call on you one day, knock on your door, and say, hey, I need a work, or maybe your work and my work, we can collaborate. It really does seem to be a business, you know. Funerals are a business, and tough, because a lot of these old people have dementia and Alzheimer's, and so they're not making these big statements. You know, they're not making a big business statement for their children and their children's children. They are not. They're just saying, Everybody just go do what you want, relax, don't take plane flights. It is tedious, we know this. We know they put you through the metal detections and the, the bare feet and all of this. We know all this drama. So no, funerals have become another no networker. They're trying, everything has been downgraded, costs, nobody wants to pay for it. So we have major downgrades so far that, you know, you just want to go out to Village Inn? No, I don't even think people want to go to Village Inn. I mean, it's that much of a disaster. It's a disaster to die with these Alzheimer and dementia cases, because one, they've gone on for so long. The people are just devastated by their experience dealing with the disease of it. It's been so draining that, oh my gosh, and now I gotta make a big funeral? I know, it's just, I understand, I would understand for sure everybody saying no, just run away from it. Today I heard a man playing the saxophone out on the big mesa, and that's it. Maybe that was enough. Maybe that was it. Maybe that for this particular instance is fine. But, you know, it's not going to be a network moment, that saxophone man. And not everybody heard him. But he was great. It was wonderful to have him out there playing music. It was just perfect. It was just apropos for a funeral. Instead, you know, instead of the funeral, instead of the service, you just listen to that guy as you're driving by in the car. I mean, it's just ridiculous. And then I'm like, well, I'm supposed to give him money for his playing of and she left or whatever music, because saxophone is kind of like that. It's like always like the sorrow guy that he never gets the girl. She runs away. She leaves him, and now he's left. You know, out in the streets, and I'm like, oh my god, it's melodramatic. You know, melodramatic sad love. One left, and the other stays. Yeah, the heartbroken male scenario. So that was for me just great. But I know I can imagine the people who are network hungry, starved. Yeah. Well, anyway, so much for you. That's all I was trying to say, is there's the benefit of the funeral large, of the service large, and then there is the other benefit, not, of course, because of cost and because of rifts. You don't have to talk to people you don't ever want to talk to. You don't even have to look at them. You can just keep going along your life and just say, hey, forget it. I don't ever have to look at that person. Ta-da. Fabulous. Fabulous. So yeah, it suits the rift factor, you know. When there is no service, everybody just fly away on your airplanes. Go to Canada, go to Rio de Janeiro, go off to Madagascar. Stay here, or go to Munich. And it's Oktoberfest, isn't it? Or it was. Go try to have a beer. You know. Those are fun too. That's another fun way. That word is getting me lately. Something to do with my apathetic tone. Alright guys, that's it. Painting cars. Digging up masonry, making bigger garden, and oh my gosh, and covering piping. So that's what I'm up to. Yikes. Happy funeral, no funeral to you. And also, do we call a funeral anymore if there's no coffin? I think you call it, look at me, I'm like smiling about this. But it is a release in a way, when a person that was hindered a long time is released from that physical that physical space that was so tough. So here I am, I'm thinking of, I think they call it services now. They probably don't even call it a funeral. That's all I've been doing. And painting that car. $21, it's gonna be beautiful. No, it still shows underneath. You can see the spots. But it's better. Anyway, ciao, good night.